It's my birthday. Can I ask for something? Kiss me.
New scenes from the most eagerly anticipated film of the year.
I love you.
And my only reason to stay. Why? If that's what I am.
It all started last November when Bella and Edward's burning desire for each other first hit screens.
I don't have the strength to stay away from you anymore.
You don't.
Now anticipation for the sequel has reached a fever pitch. When the first movie won Best Kiss at the MTV Movie Awards, the audience went bonkers for Kristen and Robert's almost kiss.
Thank you so much.
It was Kristen's idea. My idea was so terrible for it that they all got rejected. So I'm happy she told me 2 minutes before it happened.
You were great, though.
Yeah, I was just like, I'm not going to kiss you.
Now, behind the scenes of New Moon. Back alley entrances, fake names on the call sheet, and mounted police guarding the set. It is one of the most secretive productions ever made, and we're taking you inside.
3, 2, 1.
Set the record straight for us. How much of Edward and Bella together will we see in this movie?
It's kind of as close as possible to the book as you can get.
Secrets to the sequel? Number one, you get more Edward than the book originally prescribes.
The visions, we call them. In the book, it's supposed to be that she only hears him, but she actually does see him in front of her. So you will get more Robert Pattinson than you'd expect from reading it.
It's an illusion when he appears, and it's actually quite scary because Bella's, I guess, if you really look at it, she's kind of going a little bit nuts. She's trying to get over me, but it's just, I don't know, it becomes an addiction, just having these hits of seeing me.
Yeah.
Twilight ended with Edward and Bella dancing at the prom, but fans of the series know that this is no happily ever after. In the Twilight saga New Moon, Edward breaks up with Bella to save her. He leaves only to haunt her soul and her mind.
There's a lot of kind of weird dreams about like death and decay, making it sound really romantic.
Sequel secret number two, Edward reveals more of his dark side.
The dream sequences are really eerie. It's like you have something that is your idea of like perfection, but you're afraid of it while afraid of losing it. It's like very masochistic.
So the lion fell in love with the lamb.
What a stupid lamb.
Sick, masochistic lion.
He gets a chance to be a little bit more scary in the dream sequence. It's not so perfect.
Breaking in nearly $400 million worldwide, 3 million DVDs sold the first day. Obsessed fans across the globe have propelled Kristen Stewart and Robert Pattinson to superstardom.
It's quite difficult when you see like all these people, you think in one way or another you have to please them. Because like, the scream is like a scream of like wanting or whatever, but I mean, I don't know what people want.
Well, Robert, what they want is more details. Author Stephanie Meyer has sequel secret number three.
I took it to some extremes in New Moon, and I think it's kind of an emotional roller coaster experience. You hear that a lot, a little cathartic for me anyway. Probably not what you're expecting unless you've looked at spoilers.
That emotional roller coaster is the love triangle between Bella, vampire love Edward, and her pal Jacob, played by Taylor Lautner.
I leave you alone for 2 minutes, and the wolves descend.
It's really exciting that I get to bring alive this part of Jacob that you've never seen before. But yeah, you can feel the pressure at moments.
She has a best friend that it, you know, would do absolutely anything for her. And he's the right choice. But there's something about like true love.
And the more I don't come back, the more she thinks like, yeah, well, should I settle for the compromise? I mean, he didn't want me. Edward didn't want me.
You like me, right?
Right.
It's because of him.
It's like you can't describe it. It's like maybe it's not good for me, but I'm gonna ignore the better option and I'm just gonna hold out for the best.
It's so depressing for Jacob, because you find the love of your life and you're always gonna know you're gonna be second best.
Secret number four, the answer to the question everyone's dying to know.
In real life, if you had to choose an Edward girl or a Jacob girl,
I can't. Like, I'm not even allowed to answer, I guess.
If you had a sister, would you want her to date Edward or Jacob?
at its wealthier.